This is Land of Havilah, Luke 6b. When Jesus healed the man with the withered hand on the Sabbath, the Pharisees conspired against him to kill him, Matthew 12:14. Jesus perceived it, Matthew 12:15, and moved on with great crowds following. He's now on a flat spot on a mountain preaching to the multitudes, Luke 6:17 and Matthew 5:1. Verse 27. But I tell you who hear, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, and pray for those who mistreat you. To him who strikes you on the cheek, offer also the other. And from him who takes away your cloak, don't withhold your coat also. Give to everyone who asks you, and don't ask him who takes away your goods to give them back again. Comment: Jesus says some surprising and unfamiliar things. Love your enemies, turn the other cheek. If anyone steals, don't defend your property, but offer the thief even more, and don't ask for any of the stolen goods back. None of this makes sense according to any of our instincts or according to the law of the land. Shouldn't we defend ourselves and our goods from attackers? This went beyond the law of Moses, which God gave. In the law, a person has a right to defend his life and property. And if someone breaks in and steals, the homeowner bears no guilt for injuring or killing the thief, Exodus 22, 2 and 3. But if we do what Jesus just said, if we don't defend ourselves or our goods, it would be a placement of great faith in God that God would uphold us in the end against all so-called common sense. All this makes sense only if we believe there's a God in heaven who makes everything right. In every case, we should love and pray for our enemy and bear no hard feelings. Verse 31. As you would like people to do to you, do exactly so to them. Comment: that was the golden rule, do to others as you would have them do to you. It has its roots in the law of Moses, quote, you shall love your neighbor as yourself, Leviticus 19:18. Someone might say the golden rule sounds nice on paper, but it's just a platitude. It's completely impractical. No one could survive if he actually practiced it. If anyone would apply it consistently, it wouldn't take long until he had given away all his possessions and had nothing left. But that would be a great misunderstanding of the golden rule. The rule isn't treat others the way they want you to treat them. That would be fraught with all sorts of nonsense because there are completely self-centered people out there who expect everyone else to be their total servants. But that's not the golden rule. It's treat others the way you want to be treated. If we're reasonable people, we don't want people serving us to the point that it's harming them. Therefore, the golden rule doesn't require us to serve others unreasonably. Basically, we have to spend a lot more time putting ourselves in the other person's shoes and upholding the same standards for them that we hold for ourselves. But it's still a good thing to go beyond our own standard in their service, if we choose. Verse 32. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to receive back as much. But love your enemies, and do good, and lend, expecting nothing back, and your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, for He is kind toward the unthankful and evil. Therefore be merciful, even as your Father is also merciful. Comment: Jesus summed up the last four verses when He said, love your enemies, do good to them, lend and expect nothing back. God's kind to the unthankful and evil, and will be His children if we're the same. Verse 37. Don't judge and you won't be judged. Don't condemn and you won't be condemned. Set free and you will be set free. Give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be given to you. For with the same measure you measure, it will be measured back to you. Comment: God keeps account. We reap what we sow. Galatians 6:7. Verse 39. He spoke a parable to them. Can the blind guide the blind? Won't they both fall into a pit? A disciple is not above his teacher, but everyone, when he is fully trained, will be like his teacher. Why do you see the speck of chaff that is in your brother's eye, but don't consider the beam that is in your own eye? Or how can you tell your brother, "Brother, let me remove the speck of chaff that is in your eye," when you yourself don't see the beam that is in your own eye? You hypocrite, first remove the beam from your own eye, and then you can see clearly to remove the speck of chaff that is in your brother's eye. Comment: Jesus is complaining that there are too many people out there giving bad advice and unsound teaching. Let's make sure we know what we're talking about, or we should just keep quiet, especially when it comes to spiritual things. And let's be sure we practice what we preach. Verse 43. For there is no good tree that produces rotten fruit, nor again a rotten tree that produces good fruit. Each tree is known by its own fruit, for people don't gather figs from thorns, nor do they gather grapes from a bramble bush. The good man, out of the good treasure of his heart, brings out that which is good, and the evil man, out of the evil treasure of his heart, brings out that which is evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. Comment: A person's words and actions come from his heart and reflect the condition of his heart. Coming up, Luke's short version of the Sermon on the Mount ends on the same subject as Matthew's longer version, with Jesus giving an admonition about not just hearing, but doing. Verse 46. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and don't do the things which I say? Everyone who comes to me and hears my words and does them, I will show you what he is like. He's like a man building a house, who dug and went deep and laid a foundation on the rock. When a flood arose, the stream broke against that house and could not shake it because it was founded on the rock. But he who hears and doesn't do is like a man who built a house on the earth without a foundation, against which the stream broke and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great. Comment: The Sermon on the Mount's foundational. If a man hears and does, he'll not be shaken. If he hears and doesn't do, he'll be ruined. Luke 7 is next at landofhavilah.net. Luke 7.